All right, here we are. Game two between IG and Ehome Keen. They started while I was in the bathroom. That's not cool. So, IG, Ehome Keen, let's take a look at the draft thus far as we kind of try to catch up. IG, back to the Centaur, back to the Lina. Why not? It worked. They ban out the Magnus, Abaddon, and Jug, and for Ehome Keen, they ban out the Monkey King, the Life Stealer, and the Earth Spirit, picking up Legion and Crystal Maiden. Dire team back. So, let's see if Ehome Keen follow that up with a Tusk. Usually, not usually, but we've seen it a couple times where Crystal Maiden has been teamed up with a Tusk, and Tusk has been banned out pretty early. So, let's see if they head that direction for IG. Maybe it's a repeat draft for them. Nobody that they used the last game has been banned out yet. So we'll have to see. So Jug banned out by IG. Tinker from Ehome Keen. Let's see what's up last for him. As if I had to be a betting man for IG, maybe they pick up the Invoker again. Not a bad choice for them. Could go back to the Venge burning. And there's nothing stopping them at this moment in time. And IG, the draft worked out for them. Despite being down 6,000 net worth about 20 minutes in, they ended up winning the game with just about ease. So, we take a look, Ehome Keen, they get this third pick. They've got the Crystal Maiden, they've got the Legion Commander. We'll see where that Legion is going to go. Of course, Legion Jungle. And, you know, let's see what they pick up next. They've got the Frostbite of Crystal Maiden and the Slow from the Crystal Maiden as well. What'd I say? They've got the stun of Crystal Maiden. Frostbite of Crystal Maiden is what I think I wanted to say. I'm not too sure if I said it. I can't even remember. But now they go mid with the Shadow Fiend. So Shadow Fiend, Legion Commander, not a bad choice. Get that duel, get that Requiem. Get that Frostbite, get that Requiem. So overall, pretty solid combination for Ehome Keen. And Shadow Fiend, he hits pretty hard. You know, getting towards that mid, getting towards that late game, Shadow Fiend hits very hard. And IG, they've got the Lina, they've got the Centaur. And there it is. Back to the core Venge. You know, people were shitting on it last game, as it didn't work out for the early game. But Venge takes a little while to come online. It's not instant. And now Venge going to be back with Burning Venge, Centaur, XSS, Lina, Boboka again. Could go back to the Invoker on OP and Undying played by Q. Why not repeat the draft? I mean, it worked out so well. Nobody's banned up. They've already got the first three picks for it the same. Might as well take it all the way. So Ehome Keen, they've got the Shadow Fiend, they've got the Crystal Maiden and Legion. So they've got a bit of lockdown. Maybe want a bit more in another stun. So let's see what they choose to pick up. Oh no, they pick up a Naga. And I don't know if you guys saw me cast on Beyond the Summit from IsGG and MapleStory Gods the last time there was a Naga in my game. It went 80 minutes long. So let's pray, please, that it doesn't go that way again. So Naga, Shadow Fiend, Crystal Maiden, Legion Commander. Eventually, Naga's a hero that takes a long time to get online, really have that ability to push out with the Radiance and all that. Just Radiance, Manta style. Hopefully, Ehome Keen can even get to that point. As IG, once they were past that 15-20 minute mark, they really just, they snowballed into a big, easy win. So we got to see if Ehome Keen can kind of change it this time around. If they have the ability to hold on to a 6,000 net worth lead. And even if they're behind, of course, now with a Naga, no lead is safe from IG. Let's see if IG goes to the Undying. I guess that'll be my guess, because why not? Although, they could go to the Lion. Wouldn't be too bad in this situation. And they end up going for the Bounty Hunter. So, they want to take a lead, and they want to extend it with the track as much as they can. IG, now Bounty Hunter, Venge, Lina, Centaur, and Bounty Hunter. He's going to use that Shadow Walk, looking to get some vision for the Venge. Like, that's really where you're coming in. You're trying to get those swaps with the Magic Missile, obviously into the Light Strike Array, and the rest of the team for IG. It's going to work out with that Bounty Hunter. So Lina going to be 4 Bounty Hunter 5, but really with the track gold that could come in, we could see a bump in items for IG, especially towards that mid game where Venge really starts to pick up, gets that Yasha, gets that Solar Crest, and with the track gold you can push those items in. If you get that many track kills, you can push it forward even more. So let's see what they choose to do with that and how it's going to affect their item progression and how they attack this E-Home team. So they're going to ban out the Invoker. So the draft's a little bit different, obviously different with the Bounty Hunter, but let's see what they do mid this time for OP. He didn't have the best of starts last game as the Invoker. Got ganked a couple of times. I think he died like 3 times early, but towards the end of the game, his net worth was top. So IG, they ban out the Pudge, as it's looking as though it's going to be Naga safe lane, Shadow Fiend mid, Legion Commander off lane, and they pick up the Luna. So that kind of changes up the draft to me a little bit, because you think this Venge is going to be in the safe lane. You could throw Luna mid, but Luna is usually in the safe lane. Maybe they're switching it up completely, where they put Venge in the 4 spot, Bounty in the 5 spot, or Bounty in the 4 spot, Venge in the 5 spot, Lina mid, Luna safe lane, Centaur off lane, and Eon Keen. Right now it looks as though, like I said, Naga safe lane, Shadow Fiend mid, and Legion Commander off lane. So last pick's going to be coming out for Eon Keen. See what they pair it up with. They've got some pretty solid amounts of lockdown. They've got the ensnare. They've got the frostbite. Duel is there, but they could use one more stun, and maybe we see them pick up an Ogre Magi. Wouldn't be bad with this lineup. Bloodlust with Shadow Fiend, Legion Commander, always nice. The Fire Blast will be there. And he's a pretty tanky support, so I like him with this lineup of Eon Keen. And as I was saying earlier, you usually do see a Crystal Maiden teamed up with a Tusk, and that's what they do, and they go with it last. So sets up pretty well for Keen. Sleep into Requiem. Early game, you've got the Tusk Snowball as well as the Crystal Maiden Frostbite. We'll see if they go for a kill early on. I wouldn't be surprised if they do a 5-man smoke. For IG, we'll have to see where each of these heroes go, and see if they do go back to the Burning Venge. Someone just said, why do I read heroes left to right? That's funny. So we'll be ready to go in just a moment. The planning phase is there. We don't really get to see any of that. It's still just this waiting screen. You don't get to see who picks what. I don't like that. I think it should come back to the old way, where you see who picks what hero, and you kind of get the ability to really know what's going on before it turns into that next screen. We'll be right back. So game two between IG and Ehome Keen. We see Q is going to be on the Venge this time around. OP mid with the Lina, Boboka on the Bounty Hunter. That leaves Luna for burning. And then finally back to Centaur's XSS. XXS. And Dark now on the Legion Commander. Over on the CM is Wrong again. Which people were saying it's pronounced Ron or Rune. But I'm not too sure if that's right. And then another correction is going to be on the Naga. It's not Zhai Zhai Zhai. Apparently with the hard Z, it's soft like a J. Zhai Zhai Zhai. Which I could be wrong. Chat could be wrong. But I'm going to trust them. Why wouldn't you trust Twitch chat? Obviously. So. Let's see how these lanes progress for each team. And how it goes for IG. Their lineup, it kind of got swapped up as that Luna came into it. You know, you thought they were going to go similar with Burning on the Venge again, but he's now on the Luna. They do have a lot of lockdown for IG with the Lucent Beam as well as the Magic Missile, Hoof Stomp, Light Strike Array. So they can really stun lock a bunch of these heroes on Ehome, and that's what they need to be careful about if you're Ehome. You need to be careful about on IG is letting this game go to 80 minutes and let a Naga have her way. So we see these lanes form up. XXS on the Centaur. Not sure why I'm having trouble with that. This second game, OP mid with the Luna. Obviously safe lane Luna with Burning. Q on the Venge. And then Boboka already very low. Running away. And it's going to be off lane Dark. Coming over mid is the Shadow Fiend. He's here with the CM and the Tusk, who might be ultimately looking for a snowball into a frostbite, and they could maybe line that up for JJJ on the Naga up against this Centaur. And they could even line it up mid up against OP. Not a lot of health for Alina early on, only 2 armor, so a snowball into a frostbite with a couple of raises coming out from Shadow Fiend would be enough to take out Alina, so has to definitely be careful, and has to be careful up top. You've got the Magic Missile available. There it is on Dark. Now you've got the Slow of the Orb of Venom, but no Lucent Beam coming out from Burning, as he doesn't have it queued just yet, or skilled just yet, as he's only level 1. So Dark's going to have a tough time up top. Last time we saw him start down low with the Slardar, that didn't work out for him too well. And let's see if he has the same problems up top. Definitely could find himself in a bit of trouble. And here he is, pretty deep again. Q, Magic Missile available, but there it is. Dark getting pretty low, about half health. Does use the overwhelming odds on 3. And finds himself far enough away to escape. So Dark's still alive. So we take a look over at JJJ on the Naga. Just farming away, top of the CS list at 10-1. XXS is here on the Centaur, does grab himself boots. We'll see how long it is until he gets that Blink Dagger if he goes for the Hood of Defiance first. And then let's take a look. Again over mid, as I'm surprised the CM and the Tusk haven't made a rotation just yet. Okay. Missing first blood, they get the kill on the Shadow Fiend. So I'm just looking aimlessly around the map, and again, I miss first blood. I would love a camera guy. Much better than me. So they get the kill. Let's assume it went this way. Let's all have a little bit of an imagination time. So we think, close our eyes, imagine. Coming over is the Venge with the Bounty Hunter. They get a look towards mid. There's the Magic Missile with the Light Strike Array. Comes in, and then Bounty Hunter gets a nice Orb of Venom hit. Slows down Shadow Fiend, and finishing off is the Lina. And that's how First Blood went down. Did you imagine that all in your head? Did you like that? It was nice. So there's the Lucent Beam as well as the Wave of Terror coming in from Q. They do have the Magic Missile to follow it up. They start to hit away at Dark. Dark's going to ultimately get blocked by this Bounty Hunter. Overwhelming odds is used, but there's another Lucent Beam. And Boboka gets the kill on Dark. So 2-0 in favor of IG. So 2-0 for IG. 4 minutes in. Luna having a pretty solid time. And Burning doing all right. Has that Wraith Band. No boots just yet. We'll switch it over the net worth early. As we take a look over mid. Here comes Wrong. Here comes the Tusk. They're looking for that Snowball with the Frostbite. Let's see if they make the move. They do have Snowball. They do have Ice Shards. They do have full mana on Shadow Fiend, so they do have the raises possible to hit on OP. But OP does have double damage. A nice Light Strike Array could cause some problems. There's the Snowball in. They do get the Ice Shards out. And now getting very low is OP. And there is the Light Strike Array. Getting low is Tusk. But there's three here for Ehome, and they'll get themselves their first kill. Take a look up top again. Dark getting got on one more time. There's the overwhelming odds. Can they get another kill? Not enough mana for Lucent Beam just yet. And it will take a couple of shots from the tower is Burning, as just getting out of harm's way is Dark. Moon's blessings. So it looks as though they tried to go again mid onto this OP Lina. They don't end up getting themselves the kill. That's two heroes in a row that just get out with a sliver of life. We take a look over at Boboka. Let's see, what level is he? He's only level 2, so he does have the Shuriken Toss as well as this nice Shadow Walk, but we'll see if he can get involved in a couple of more kills. There's the Snowball coming through with the Ice Shards, but coming over with the Shuriken Toss is Boboka. They get the Stampede out, and now they look to turn it around as they've got Q. There's the Magic Missile coming through. One more shot would do it. They get the Dragon Slave of OP and get the kill on Tusk. They turn around their aggression with the Stampede coming out from the Centaur. So they turn it around, they get themselves a nice kill, it goes the way of OP. So after dying, it's a nice comeback kill now at 2-1. So the scan comes out from the Radiant. They are actually going to spot Q. They don't know it's him. Maybe they expect it to be Boboka. And Q just sitting nearby in this jungle, just kind of roaming around. Ends up heading on back. So does Boboka, who's just kind of roaming around this jungle, not really getting too involved. You know, I'd really like to see him get an earlier level 6, start to get those track kills for IG. And really ultimately pull away in the net worth. But already level 7 is XXS. And now Wrong coming over, maybe trying to get a kill with JJJ. And let's see what they can do down low. Wrong only level 4, has one in Crystal Nova, one in the Frostbite, 2 in the Arcane Aura. But backing off all the way is XXS. Still just trying to farm up this Hood of Defiance. Meanwhile, up top, Burning has found himself level 6. He'll be looking to finish off those power treads. And there it is. So the aggression kind of stops on both sides. Meanwhile, Boboka, and as I say that, they go in on him. There's the Dust. He gets under tower, but a raise hits. There's the Stampede to get him out. Now trying to turn it around is Q. Can find a Magic Missile, maybe they get the kill, but he eats a raise, and him himself will have to back off there too. So they get the Hood of Defiance out onto XXS, and now let's see how aggressive IG are looking to be. The Double Edge really doesn't bother him too much. He gets down low, and XXS sitting close to the top of the net worth, only a little bit behind OP, who is level 7. And then a bit behind this Naga, who's at 3,700 net worth, level 7, just about level 8, and probably looking for that Radiance next. So coming over is OP and Q. They don't have Swap. They have the Wave of Terror, which they can line up with the Magic Missile. Illusion does not spot them. Doesn't break smoke. We all know that. But the Naga has backed all the way off. So OP and Q, they're not going to find anything. They come in with the hopes of killing off Naga Siren. And they use the Wave of Terror, they look through the trees, not there, and OP and Q. He's gonna just back off. JJJ just has to use these illusions just to kind of push, get a couple of last hits. Really can't move forward in lane as knowing that OP and Q are most likely nearby. But over top, we take a look. Tusk is here with the Crystal Maiden. Dark is level 6, looking for the first dual win. And let's see if they can go in on Boboka as they do walk in, and hopefully they have Dust. There it is. There's the overwhelming odds, and there's the press. The attack should be a dual win, and it will be. But there's the Stampede with the Hoofstomp Double Edge coming through and obliterates Dark on the back end. Lucent Beam now thrown forward by Burning. Tusk in a whole bunch of trouble, and another Double Edge. It's a double kill from XXS. And it's a 2-for-1 trade in favor of IG. So 5-2 in favor of IG. Take a look over at OP down low, just trying to farm up as much as he can while the Centaur is at a lane. He'll occupy it. And IG, they found themselves a nice 2,000 net worth lead. Now they're going to want to extend this, of course, with the track. And now picking up that Bounty Rune, getting to level 5 is Boboka. One level away from finally having it. And then maybe we see this IG net worth really expand. So now Magic Missile, Lucent Beam flies through. They use the Eclipse. They're trying to chase down this Shadow Fiend. He's running back. Boboka is here and trying to set up. Maybe his Shadow Fiend here with Ron. He does actually get out. I'm surprised he was able to get himself back to tower. Thought for sure he might be dead. But with the first half of Eclipse really only hitting on the Tusk and not on the Shadow Fiend, they don't get the kill onto the Shadow Fiend. He does have the ability to survive, get back towards the shrine, and heal up. So that kill does end up going towards Burning. He's looking for a nice Yasha next. Dire's middle tower is under attack. So Dark only has 10 dual damage. We take a look actually up top as there it is. I mean, a lot of trouble is this Bounty Hunter, and there's the Raze with Wrong. They get a kill again on Bounty Hunter, who is still yet to be level 6. Take him out of the equation once more, and it's now 6-3 for IG. So the net worth does start to tilt, maybe back towards the even line. Meanwhile, let's take a look over at OP, who is level 10 and takes that first talent of minus 30-second respawn time. So the three of them, Q, OP, and XXS, now with the Blink Dagger out on the Centaur, they're looking to smoke up, make an aggressive play towards top, and they are going to head all the way over. They do have the ability to get these nice stun lock with IG, and they're coming over. They're looking to get a kill on Dark. The smoke's going to be popped, and now let's see if they head over trying to get Tusk. Tusk is going to be in the trees, has the ability to just TP out, and nothing is gained from that smoke from IG. So IG, guess they sort of force back the likes of Ehome. and they'll look to take a tier 1 tower, so the smoke does pressure them back. But there's the Glyph in XXS. He does have that Blink Dagger, so really has to be careful is Dark. We take a look down low as now they're going in again on Boboka. They get the kill, still not level 6, and they will Song and TP out for JJJ. Just continuing to push forward. They get the tier 1. Q getting pretty low, needs to be careful. That is the combination of Q burning and OP. They combine to get that tier 1 down low. And now they're looking for the snowball in. There's the blink out, but it is going to hit. Now they get the ice shards down. Ron looking for something. He gets the crystal nova. Now let's see what they can get with the frostbite. They get it down, and there it is. Hood of Defiance is popped, and the stampede will find him in escape with just over 100 health. Meanwhile, up top, Q gets the kill on Dark. So, you know, you look down low, you think XXS is gonna die, and as you're looking at how much health he's left with, and if he dies up top, there's a kill. You can't keep the camera on two spots at once. I don't have that kind of production value over here. And you're missing kills left and right. Somebody buy me a producer. So OP going for that Bloodstone next, level 11. Let's take a look over at the Centaur. He's level 12, has taken the 35 damage with that first talent. And then finally, level 6 is Boboka. So here it comes. Track Gold is going to be there if they get more kills, hopefully. It's still just 7-4. They're averaging less than a kill a minute. Been sort of a slow game, which is no surprise for a Naga game, and we haven't really taken a look at that Naga in quite some time, who has the Sacred Relic. So getting very close to that Radiance, and they really need to make something happen against JJJ, and now he's under a Sentry Ward, and again, Boboka will fall. Not before getting track out on the Crystal Maiden, but it doesn't mean all too much. So coming out next is going to be the Heart for Centaur, Q, just as Tranquils and that Wind Waste. Now coming over, they're going to use the Stampede. They get the swap out into the Hoofstomp as well as the Light Strike Array, and the Laguna Blade will grant them the kill. Meanwhile, Burning will find a kill onto the Crystal Maiden. So two kills happen at the same time. Again, we don't have that split-screen technology over here. We only catch one, so we catch the more important one, and that's the Legion Commander done. And also, this Tier 1 denied. So they'll come all the way over to Shrine to heal up. Get their mana back and then look to smoke as they move over mid once again. So Shadow Fiend and Tusk are nearby. Boboka with the Shadow Walk is going to spot the Tusk. They're still continuing to go in deep. There it is. Blink, Hoofstomp, Double Edge. There's the Magic Missile. He's tracked up. And the first track kill is there for IG. Q's going to get credit for that kill. Laguna Blade just wipes the Tusk off the map. And it'll be another 2-0 for IG. Maybe you wanted to wait just a little bit for the track on that Laguna Blade. So 11-5 in favor of IG, and they've got a 6,000 net worth lead. So looking pretty good for IG as they've taken this nice lead with Luna. Let's take a look at Burning. He's got that Mantisile, but then over on the Naga, the Radiance has been finished. And if I could put something on the screen that just was a nice blinking red light of 80-minute game incoming, you guys would all hate me because I put it over the entire screen, but you know there is most likely an 80-minute game incoming with this Naga Siren. This'll come in handy. Visibility. So let's try and go around the horn again as we take a look at this Tusk. Just has boots, Crystal Maiden, the same can be said, but it is Tranquils. Now, actually, OP, they're looking for the kill. They do get the dust out on Boboka, but it's not going to matter as the Light Strike Array and the Laguna Blade and Track come out yet again for IG. They get another kill. So we take a look at the net worth. It's burning up top by about 1,000 gold. And then up next is that Naga Siren. Scary in the thoughts of a long game coming out from this. And then we take a look over at the Lina, who's next on the net worth. Has that Bloodstone at 14 charges, so doing pretty well with it. As they're now grouping up as four. Looking to get themselves... Oh, I was going to catch the end of that. Up top, XXS dies, and IG, they're looking bottom. They're looking to get a tier 2. They've got the glaives bouncing around, and there's the track out on Dark. But they don't have the blink hoof stomp, and now coming in is Dark. He's blinked on forward. He might have put himself in a little bit of trouble. There's the Lucent Beam as well as the Eclipse. That is not the right move. Blink way too aggressively. There's the song. They're trying to turn it around. They don't line it up with a Requiem of Souls. It will be Q who sacrifices his life for the greater good of OP, who may not get out, just gets pushed forward by those ice shards, and actually does escape. So it's a 2-for-1 trade. That's the Centaur dying up top, as well as the Venge down low, getting the swap out on the Lina to keep the Lina alive, keep those Bloodstone charges safe. But they do kill the Legion Commander, who gets really just too cocky with that blink. And, you know, you'll go too far forward. Of course, you've got yourself 20 damage. Look at you, doing so great. But to get that cocky and put yourself in between four heroes of IG. I mean, that to me just seems like a huge misplay, and that's what cost the Legion his life. And when we take a look over, it's now 15 Bloodstone charges for OP, looking towards that Shadow Blade. Let's take a look over at Burning, who's got that Dragon Lance now, and the Centaur still looking for that heart. And I'm scared to look at Naga, who's going for the Octarine Core next, but gets hit by that Lucent Beam. There's the Ensnare out on the Luna. They're trying to get something to turn it around, but Burning's still going in on JJJ, and the Lucent Beam's actually going to hit on an Illusion. And getting out is the Naga Siren. I think they were trying to ping out Burning to get a rotation, but the Crystal Maiden not going to get there in time for the Frostbite. Crystal Nova and possibly the... Oh, we take a look over mid. There it is. Blink, Hoofstomp, Magic Missile, Track, Double Edge. They get the kill over on the Tusk. And getting out with the Shadow Blade will be the Shadow Fiend. So 14-7 in favor of IG. Another Track kill for them, and that's a big boost in gold. It makes every kill worth a 700 net worth split, and they've taken a 7,500 net worth lead on the side of IG. With that, they're going to look towards taking a tier 2. There's the Double Edge with the Light Strike Ray, cleaning up this creep wave, cleaning up this tower, and they push their second tier 2 down already for IG just 22 minutes into the game. So going to be looking for that Octarine Core. JJJ does have the Boots of Travel and the Radiance, so they're going to be able to push out well. Good point, Lena. I don't understand why Crystal Maiden was there. As I was looking up top at the Naga and all that nice wealth, but apparently walking into two heroes is Crystal Maiden, thinking she's some sort of sly hero. But not really. So we take a look down low. There's the Shadow Blade finished for Lina. Now going for the Boots of Travel. Has 17 charges on this Bloodstone. We take a look at that level 15 skill. 50 damage. So now hits for 178. Let's take a look over at Burning. He's got those two on the Talent Tree. It's 150 more health. That is better than the 40... damage on the Lucent Beam. I do agree with that, but the health is all not that much. It's kind of really two poor choices for a level 15 skill. Let's take a look over at Ehome, as they've got one skill out on the JJJ on the Naga. It's only 250 mana. And then the Shadow Fiend, who is level 15, does have 175 health plus the 20 attack speed, and they are dusted up. They're looking to get a kill over on OP, who's starting to run away. They come on over with the Shadow Blade, trying to get some vision out on OP, but they're not going to find anything. No blink, no duel, no nothing for Ehome Key. Look over at IG as they just continue to farm up. Look for those next items. They're really looking to finish the heart on the Centaur over on the Venge. Just trying to get a Glimmer Cape out. For Burning, looking for the Butterfly next. And that's one of those top echelon items that Burning's going to be looking for to really take the advantage over Ehome Keen. On the other side of Ehome, we take a look at this Radiance Naga. Ugh. Looking for that Octarine Core, and just roaming around is Boboka. Just trying to scout out these heroes of Ehome Keen and looking to take advantage as they have the Blink Dagger out on Centaur if they want to come in with the Blink Hoofstomp. They get the track out, and there it is with the Shuriken tosses the Light Strike Array, strikes down wrong, and Boboka gets the track. They get the kill. It's now 8 Bloodstone charges for Lina. So IG, they get another kill and extend the net worth even more, and now they ping out Roche. They're going to head towards Roche, should be an easy kill. There's the Wave of Terror, and the Heart comes out onto XS. XXS. They've got all five here. Looking over with the overwhelming odds is the Legion Commander. They back up for just a moment. Now the Ice Shards are there. It's going to lock in XXS for a moment. But Ehome, they really need to find a way to stop this Roche from happening. The Ice Shards are thrown forward again. They're going to try to get the Blink in with the Bleed Mail and the Duel. There's the Duel out on Burning. There's the Laguna Blade to blow up this Legion Commander. And Burning's still alive. They've taken out the Legion Commander. They get the song. And now here it is, the BKB. They're charging up the Requiem right over the Centaur. But they do get the Aegis out and snatched on the Shadow Fiend. And it's only a 2-for-1. There's the Blink Hoofstomp double edge out on the Crystal Maiden. Now they maybe look to get a kill on the Shadow Fiend, but he's got that Aegis, and now they're looking to get a kill on the Centaur. JJJ gets a killing spree, getting the kill on Boboka. They get the Ensnare. There's the Light Strike Array. Gonna miss on Shadow Fiend, getting very low is XXS, and the Magic Missile will be thrown forward, and it's a 3-for-2 trade between these two teams. So we take a look at the fight recap. 1,700 gold going the way of Ehome Keen as they take out Burning, but still 1,200 for IG. And he got a couple of tracks out, did really well, and that was a duel lost, wasn't it? So 14 more damage for Burning. So it's a nice setup, nice team fight. They snatched the Aegis, and it was the nice song that came out that was followed up by the Requiem of Souls. So actually, Boboka, now the shards, there's the snowball, Walrus Punch, another duel, that should be an easy win, and there it is. So walking right into the hands of Ehome Keen as this Bounty Hunter, giving up even more duel damage to Legion Commander. And it's now at 34. Let's take a look. XXS might be in a little bit of trouble. There's the Ensnare as well as the Overwhelming Odds. They get the Stampede. He's not out just yet. The Radiant's continuing to burn. There's the Snowball with the Walrus Punch. They're locking him down long enough. There's the Ice Shards that rooted again and now just going to try and TP out, but there's the song to stop him. So they end the song. They put down the duel with the Blade Mail and even that second heart. I mean, the heart inside his chest and the heart item is not enough to save his life as they get a kill out on XXS. And 1,400 net worth going their way. So the net worth still 15,000 in favor of IG. But these pickoffs for Ehome Keane are what they need to come back into this game. It's the beginning of the nice blueprints to come back. As, you know, again, it's an 80-minute game warning alert as they have a Naga with an Octarine Core and a Radiance. The Butterfly is finished for Burning, however, and this might be the next big item for Burning to start going in on Ehome Keane with no problem. We take a look down low, TPing out his Boboka. Dark and Wrong are down here just trying to farm up as much as they can. They've got the Blade Mail, they've got the Phase Boots, and now looking for the BKB is Dark. Didn't have the easiest of times in this game thus far at 2-6-3, but has managed to accumulate 48 dual damage, which is alright. And now they head back over. OP, he's invisible. They do get the Laguna Blade and get the kill, so the Light Strike Array is enough with the Laguna Blade to get the kill. And now CM, you may have shown yourself a little bit too far, and now another kill goes the way of OP, but there it is with three heroes here for Ehome. They will destroy OP and they'll at least get one in return. Immediately back up. Thank you, Bloodstone. It's the major perks of a Bloodstone. Major perks. So meanwhile, up top, Burning is going to push that tier 2. They're here with all 5 heroes, and they are making this an easy push on the tier 3. They take down the tier 3. There it is with the song. Can they set up a Requiem? Doesn't look as though they're going to be doing that. They're just using it defensively, which, in my opinion, is a mistake. They've now used it defensively. They have no more song to really lock down these heroes of IG, and they're going to immediately pop the Aegis of this Shadow Fiend, so they don't use it too well, and there's the snowball in from this Tusk, who immediately gets tracked up. There's the Laguna Blade with the Eclipse coming through. There's the duel. It's not going to be enough. They lose the Shadow Fiend. They'll lose the Legion Commander. So three are dead. There it is. They'll get another in the Crystal Maiden. They swap back an Illusion Naga, and they lose 4 on Ehome Keane. Just, in my opinion, a misplay with the Song Impossible Requiem. They're going to lose the top set of racks. They'll lose mid-tier 3. They're going to lose the racks here, too, as Burning, he just pushes way too fast. There it is, Blink, Hoof Stomp, and now the Light Strike Array will follow it up. They take out Shadow Fiend again. It was a buyback into a dieback. Now at 83 seconds, Wrong, you're in trouble. You're dead as well. And 4 still sit dead for the side of Ehome Keane. IG will lose Boboka. They'll lose their tier 4s, and why not go straight for the win? There's the Ancient getting attacked. Down to 1,000, 800, 700, 500, 200, dead. GG called. IG, they take game one off a huge misstep from Ehome Keane in that last fight up top. So that's the end of game two. IG, they take a 2-0 win over Ehome Keane. And with that, we're going to be moving over to Beyond the Summit 3 as Manila Masters is going to be coming in on this channel. So follow me over there. They're going to get a nice hosting when I do go up immediately following the ending of the game on stream. And then I'm going to cast that last series on Beyond the Summit 3. It'll get hosted here until Manila Masters starts. I'm your caster, BCOP, at BCOP92, BKOP92 on Twitter. Follow me there. Follow me on Twitch, Gaming for Gelt, and all that. And know what I'm doing. I don't know. I talk on Twitter about random things. So let's take a look. Fight recap. I was told to show this. Let's show the graph. Let's show the scoreboard. Really, your MVP there is OP. Just doing really quite well. 666 GPM. He's the devil. And 805 for Burning. So, obviously a great game there for IG. It looked a little shaky towards the mid-end of it. But late game, they end up taking it. We'll be back with the next series on Beyond the Summit 3 in just a moment.